In this video, explore a Hello World sample for StereoKit. If you're unfamiliar with the steps to set up a StereoKit project, refer to the project setup videos for guided instruction on project setup. For this video, we'll be using the StereoKit Universal Windows Platform template. In the Solution Explorer, there is an Assets folder and a Program.cs script. The Assets folder is where you can store assets such as model files. The Program.cs script contains the application logic. The sample provided displays a rounded cube that can be grabbed and moved with your hands. When viewing the app, if you cannot see the real world around you, such as a VR experience or viewing on a PC screen, a floor is provided below the cube. StereoKit automatically provides you with hands, an environment, and lighting. Let's explore the logic that is used to generate this cube. The code first starts by initializing StereoKit. During initialization, you can prepare a few settings like the app name and assets folder. The app name is the name of the app and appears at the top of the Win32 window if viewing your app in flat screen mode. In addition, the app name is also submitted to OpenXR, which caps at 128 characters. The Assets folder is the folder that StereoKit will use to look for assets. You can refer to the reference documentation for additional settings. Next, the pose, or location of the rounded cube, is set. The pose is named Cube Pose and is positioned at 0 on the x-axis, 0 on the y-axis, and negative 0.5 meters on the z-axis with no rotation. Next, the rounded cube is created as an instance of the model class and is named Cube. A model is a collection of meshes, materials, and transforms that make up a visual element. This is a great way to group together complex objects that have multiple parts in them, and in fact, most model formats are composed this way already. The model class contains a number of methods for creation. If you pass in an OBJ, STL, GLTF, or GLB file format, StereoKit will load that model from file and assemble materials and transforms from the file information. But you can also assemble a model from procedurally generated meshes. Next, we use the FromMesh method. The FromMesh method is used to create a single mesh instance of the model class using the indicated mesh and material. A mesh is a single collection of triangular faces with extra surface information to enhance rendering. StereoKit meshes are composed of a list of vertices and a list of indices to connect the vertices into faces. Nothing more than that is stored here, so typically, meshes are combined with materials or added to models in order to draw them. A material describes the surface of anything drawn on the graphics card. It is typically composed of a shader and shader properties like colors, textures, transparency info, etc. For the mesh parameter, the generate rounded cube method is used, which returns a cube mesh with rounded corners sized to the given dimensions. The generate rounded cube method takes three parameters: dimension, edge radius, and subdivisions. Dimensions is of the type VEC3 and defines the size of the cube on each axis in meters. For this example, dimensions is set to VEC1 times 0.1. VEC1 is shorthand for a vector where all values are 1. The edge radius parameter is of the type float and defines the radius of corner rounding in meters. For this example, edge radius is set to 0.02. As for the from mesh material parameter, this parameter is set to default.material. StereoKit has a collection of default assets. For this example, the default for material is used. Next, a floor is created which displays that there is no view into the real world. As mentioned, this will occur if you're viewing the app in an immersive environment such as a VR device or on a PC screen. A floor transform is created using the TS method, which creates a transform matrix using both translate and scale. A floor material is also created which loads a shader from the assets folder named floor.hlsl. A shader is a piece of code that runs on the GPU and determines how model data gets transformed into pixels on the screen. You can provide your own shader code if you need fine control over how models are rendered. Finally, the floor material.transparency is set to blend. This marks the rendering material as having a transparent surface that can blend with the content behind it. This allows you to see through the empty parts of the floor grid, leaving only the grid lines as visible. Here in the while statement, the code draws a model every step of the application. The application steps each frame until StereoKit is told to exit. The callback code is called every frame after input and system events, but before draw events. There's a conditional statement provided to determine whether the floor displays. Essentially, if the display type is opaque, which means there's no view into the real world, then the mesh cube is drawn using the floor material and floor transform that was created above. Next, a handle is created which enables you to grab and move objects. The handle method takes three parameters: ID, pose, and handle. The ID parameter is of type string and defines the ID of the handle group. For this example, the ID is cube. The pose parameter is of type pose and defines the pose state for the handle. The user will be able to grab this handle and move it around. For this example, the cube pose is used. Finally, the handle parameter is of type bounds and defines the size and location of the handle relative to the pose. For this example, the value is set to the bounds of the cube. The draw method adds the cube model to the render queue for the current frame. This method takes one parameter, transform, which is of type matrix. This defines a matrix that will transform the model from model space into the current hierarchy space. In this example, the value for cube pose is used and converted into a transform matrix using two matrix. Finally, we can clean up StereoKit and all its resources using the shutdown method. To try out the app, let's build and deploy to HoloLens 2. If you're unfamiliar with how to build and deploy, refer to the project setup and deploy video for HoloLens. After deployment is complete, the app will start on your device. You can grab and move the cube directly with your hands using a pinching motion. If instead you choose to create this project for desktop development, you will be able to view the app on your PC screen and use your mouse to grab and move the cube. To learn more about StereoKit, visit aka.ms/StereoKit.